been mad at your mom for cleaning out your room while you went away to college or anywhere else, and she got rid of some of your cute trophies and stuff? Okay, this has nothing to do with that. Kobe Bryant and his mom are not getting along so well right now, only a few days away from Mother's Day. The NBA star is fighting with her over his memorabilia. Apparently she got like about $500,000 advance from an auction house for somewhere around 900 things. And anything that belongs to him is worth some money. We're talking about a few NBA championship rings, NBA All-Star rings, awards, and uniforms, including a few that he wore back in high school. He is trying to put a stop to the auction because he says that this is his stuff, that it's not his mom's, and that she didn't have the right to go off and auction it off and sell it and get money in advance. But Pamela Bryant says, not so fast, kiddo. She says that her son told her she could have it all. She says that she's had this stuff around for 15 years, and that for the last five, she has actually been paying $1,500 a month to keep it in a storage unit. All of those facts matter. And that's why Sonny Hostin and Paul Callan like to take facts and work with them in their analysis, our legal analysts. Okay, Paul, first to you. Do you see a case here?
Well, I kind of take it personally because in the Callan family, my wife, Eileen, who likes garage sales, sold off my son's baseball cards without telling him. It's been a scandal in the family for years. And this idea of things going into storage to accommodate the kids is troublesome as well. We're all doing it now as they leave the house. So, what will the judge look at in this case? Well, he's going to look at how long were they in the possession of the mother. Can we reasonably infer that a title had passed to the mother? Undoubtedly the same defense my wife would claim had if my son chose to sue. You know, that's what the fight's going to be about. But it's not a good Mother's Day thing.
No. Terrible timing. So, Sonny, you know how everybody always says, hey, possession is 9/10 of the law. I'm not sure that that's in statute anywhere, but kind of doesn't that really mean a lot?
I think it may mean a lot. I mean, it's been there for quite some time, right? I mean, Kobe Bryant has a pretty big home. He certainly, if he wanted it, would have taken possession of it. And so I think that's one of the arguments that we're going to hear. But bottom line, Ashley, I mean, who does this? I mean, if his mother needs the money, remember Kobe Bryant bought his wife a $4 million, $5 million ring when they were having troubles. Why can't he just give his mother some money if his mother does need the money? I mean, the fact that he filed the cease and desist order, I think it just makes you go, ugh, who does that?
I know, it's really uncomfortable all around. But, Paul, I do come back to the idea of Kobe Bryant living in his mom's house as a minor. I mean, minors have rights. Parents don't like to think so a lot of times. I know I don't think so when it comes to my 5- and 7-year-old. But they do have rights, don't they? They do have belongings, don't they?
Well, they do. And in all seriousness, this is very different than selling baseball cards. These are, for instance, one of the rings, the championship rings, has been valued at possibly worth more than $100,000.
Wow.
And there are other pieces of memorabilia that could push it as high as $150,000, $200,000 possibly. So we're talking about enormous amounts of money. And could Kobe Bryant really have gifted this to his mother without telling her explicitly he was doing that? Sounds to me like he kind of just left the stuff behind and never intended to transfer it over to mom.
I think that my downhill skiing medal from like 78 might fetch 82 cents on eBay. So my mom has nothing to worry about. Sonny Hostin and Paul Callan, thank you both. We'll continue to watch that story for the developments there as well. Coming up, I want to take you to Philadelphia.